Being sun smart and protecting your skin from sunburn isn't just for summer. Sun damage can happen year round, so we met with the experts at Pariser Dermatology to talk about how to protect yourself and reduce the skin cancer risk factors. Tell me what melanoma is and what are some of the common misconceptions people have about it?
So melanoma is one of the deadliest forms of skin cancer that we treat. Thankfully, it's one of the more rare forms, but for patients that do have melanoma, they're at a much more risk of dying from their disease. Some of the misconceptions about melanoma are the patients that are affected. Anybody can get melanoma. It actually is the most common form of cancer overall in patients in their 20s. It's the second most common cancer overall in children. So it's not just something that affects elderly patients. Mm-hmm. Other misconceptions are some people think that only people that are fair complected, like myself, are at risk for skin cancer, and that's not the case. Mm-hmm. Patients of all skin tones can get skin cancer. As a matter of fact, Bob Marley, who was a very known, well-known reggae musician, died from metastatic melanoma on his toe. That brings up another misconception. Some patients think that melanoma only occurs on areas in sun exposure. Although in most patients it is more common in areas where we get more sunburns, it can occur on areas that are sun protected, including the hands, the feet, and the genitalia.
Right, and we live in an area where, you know, people spend a lot of time at the beach and outdoors. So is there an extra cause for concern?
Absolutely. Patients that get a lot of large doses of sun exposure that leads to sunburns and blistering sunburns are at a much higher risk. They actually have done studies that shows that one blistering sunburn in your lifetime will double your chance of getting melanoma. Five regular sunburns also doubles your chance. Wow. So those are two things that growing up here or living here at the beach is going to increase a patient's overall risk over their lifetime.
Sunburns is something to look out for. What are other warning signs?
So warning signs of melanoma are basically any lesion on the skin that's changing. Most melanomas present as pigmented lesions, meaning they're going to have pigment in them. They're going to be brown or black. We recommend that patients look for any lesion on their skin that's rapidly changing, so a mole that's looking different over time. There is a form of melanoma that does not have pigment, so it can present as a pink bump. So basically, a warning sign is anything in the skin that's changing quickly over time, and that's why we recommend coming in and having your skin checked at least once a year for us to look for those things.
Tanning beds are in the news a lot, and there's a lot of controversy about them. What do you recommend?
Well, first of all, I recommend never using a tanning bed ever. If you use a tanning bed just once in your lifetime, it may increase your risk of malignant melanoma by 20%. And if you use a tanning bed once before the age of 35, that can increase by 75%.
Wow, so a lot of dangers there. Do you have any alternatives that you can recommend?
I mean, if you have to be tan, you can use, there's creams, lotions, Jergens, Saint Tropez, those are some of the brands that we recommend. You can also do spray tanning, which you can go to a salon or get somebody to spray tan you. We also recommend if you're going to do the spray tan that you don't inhale it. So you should use nose protection, take a deep breath in, do not inhale the actual substance, the chemical.
And when we're talking about everyday skincare, what are some of the things that we can do to protect ourselves and reduce our risk of getting melanoma?
So everybody should wear sunscreen every day, no matter what skin type you have. We recommend an SPF of 30 or higher. The ingredient should have zinc and titanium dioxide. You should apply, you know, your face, your neck, your chest, your hands, just when you're driving to work every day. If you're going to be outside really going to the beach, that kind of thing, you should reapply every 2 hours. You should wear a hat and wear protective clothing as much as you can.
All right, and if they have any questions or they think they may see something, definitely get it checked out.
Definitely get it checked out. I would so much rather see a benign lesion and be like, yep, that looks okay, than somebody miss a melanoma.
Pariser Dermatology specialists have 7 locations across Hampton Roads. To schedule an appointment or to get more information, call 622-6315 or visit parisdermatology.info.